far as a carbine was.
We might as well mount. You're right. We all know where that smoke and those flames come from.
Not much more than, but it's enough to finish the offer. You're not supposed to see and hear out before the
him.
No, don't worry, I'll begin. Jonathan, thank you for... Ah, who's a smart young man then?
Blood is thicker than water. Off you go then, the three of you.
Elizabeth, please, I've got work to do.
So there you are, Spender.
You go on, I'll be there in a minute.
So you're going through with it then?
Of course.
So I suppose this new happily married man won't be coming to the union meeting next week.
It's my wedding day, Lewis. A union meeting is the last thing on my mind.
Right.
So I'm Harry. Already has he dancing to that tune? Nobody has me dancing to any tune. Not I'm Harry. And not you!
So are you coming to the union meeting or not?
Are you coming to my wedding or not?
See you then.
You have a wife. Have you forgotten what it's like to be in love?
You and Lewis, you're planning to change the world?
I told you, I'm done with all that.
Shouldn't we be at the chapel by now?
I just couldn't stay away from you.
Bad luck to see each other before the wedding.
See you at the chapel then?
I told him to go before you came. The Bridget was never one for listening to advice. If he listened to advice, there wouldn't be a wedding at all. Would there? I won't lie, I certainly didn't encourage it. But once he makes his mind up, there's no stopping him. He is the strongest man I've ever known. I'll give you one thing. He's changed since he's been with you. No more strikes, no fighting. But life's enough of a fight, but we don't have to go looking for it. You've had more than your fair share of knots, right enough.
Thank you. money for the new chapel.
Yeah, every one of them is the same. Bastards the lot!
Calm down, Lewis. We're here to celebrate my wedding.
Aye, that's our game. More drinking! Yeah.
Alright, drinking it is!
And would you happen to be a friend of the bride or of the groom?
I am a friend of the Lord.
We're here to celebrate our wedding, and we all know you mustn't drink on a Sunday.
Sunday or any day, drink is the devil's tool.
To be sure, who was that fella in the Bible who turned water into wine? A well-known servant of the devil by the name of Jesus Christ.
And your blasphemy is clear proof that the juice of the beer addled your brain.
The juices of whores have no doubt addled mine!
Blasphemy and debauchery! You will all burn in hell!
We burn in the hell of Crawshank's furnace all day. Yeah, why don't you take your nonsense to him instead?
Nonsense? We are God's servants.
Well, these are all good men. Good chapel men.
Crawshay. I heard a rumour that you paid money toward the rebuilding of a chapel in the town. I take it that was merely idle gossip.
No, guess it's not.
Have you taken leave of your senses, man?
A token of benevolence goes a long way to winning the trust of the workers.
But a non-conformist chapel, an affront to the Church of England and to God. Worse still, the workers will see it as a sign of weakness.
Aye, this is the stubborn bugger.
Aye, how is this ring?
Well, looks like Crawshay's going to be down a few grams of coal at the end of the day.
Right, but he won't be the one feeling the loss. They'll just cut half of it.
And the price of food will keep going up.
Yeah, without Crawshay and guest table, I'm short of their full plates.
With the current rising costs, we all need to lay off workers to maintain profit. Are you telling me you're not prepared to do that just to make the workers happy?
A happy workforce is a productive workforce.
Productivity and profit are paramount. You can't cut your profit to keep paying them wages higher than you can afford.
If you owned Black Llewellyn, he came to his house, confiscated all his property, because his wages are so low, he can't pay his debts.
Oh, they tried to confiscate my property, but I couldn't put up with it.
They'll lay off more workers, they'll cut wages. Families in America are just going to start there.
We need the power of the vote.
We have the power. In our fists.
I've heard reports that some miners and iron workers who have already been clamouring for this insane idea of reform of Parliament are now being stirred up by this ruffian, Lewis Lewis, demanding more wages and an improvement in working conditions.
Yes. So I gather.
That's where your benevolent gesture leads us, Crawshay. Give them a bone, and they want to tear your hand off.
I hear you've been stirring up trouble with the men down the mines again.
The trouble's already there. I'm just helping the men see that it's there.
Union talk and work, Lewis. You could have gotten us all sacked or worse.
What the hell happened to you? When you were a boy, you led a strike.
When I was a boy, I used to go scrumping apples too. I grew up.
And you see the hell around us. Small children with broken limbs. And men with broken souls. Because they're condemned. Thank you.
leave him be, Rebecca. Lewis is boiling over.
It seems to me that Lewis is always boiling over.
He's a good man. His anger just makes him lose sight of reason.
My husband has not lost sight of reason. Everything he says is right. There are children dying in Martha because their mothers and fathers can't afford to feed them. I don't know what I'd do if I lost one of my boys.
Best he keeps a level head then. Say goodnight to Jonathan, please.
Where are you going?
Union meeting. Lewis needs someone there with a clear head.
It's just a meeting.
What next? A strike? A demonstration?
Maybe.
Richard promised me he wouldn't be part of it.
We're all part of it. The men fight for what they believe in. We stand beside them. He rushes headlong into things without a second thought. He's always going for what he thinks is right. That is why each single day I'm there to hold his hand and proudly stand beside him.
Do it now. Thank you. Richard! Get a beer, dying you.
Beer and union meetings don't mix.
So you're on, Dick Van Deren. The meeting's the very time for a beer.
Do you take anything seriously, Sean?
I take drinking very seriously.
Is Lewis in there?
Hi. In the back with the rest. You best get in there before he convinces everybody to start a revolution before tomorrow's sun rises.
And what are you doing here? Not out playing with Megan?
Her mum's a playing still to play. Then I saw Meg up in there.
Hasn't your mother ever told you to stay away from pubs and keep your distance from beer and whores? She's half right. You stay away from the whores!
You don't tell mum?
No, it's our secret, John.
Why are all the men shouting?
They're having a meeting, and they're talking about things that make them afraid. That makes them angry.
You never shout. Don't you ever get angry.
Yes, but I stop and think before I start to shout. Best you stay out of their act.
I've been appointed a special constable to keep the peace. You watch your life, or I'll give you a hiding you'll never forget.
Get your hands off him!
That was a mistake, Richard.
Damn right, I should have hit you hard.
You're under arrest!
You have to go through me. Get going, Abbott, or we knock your arse all the way back to Dallas. So, you've got some fights when you get in there. I never said I couldn't fight. I just choose my battles more wisely than you do.
Aye, punching a special constable. A real wise move. And it's we Irish who say are stupid.
There's no wisdom in letting the masters trample us into the ground without fighting back. There's too much anger in that room.
Too much hunger in that room. A man should think with his head and not his stomach.
No, a man should think with his heart. And let Crawshite and the other tyrants know that they've crossed a line and that we will not stand for it anymore. And what if they don't listen?
They'll have to listen. Or we'll make them listen.
I'm sick to my stomach. The world doesn't listen.
Spirit in the blood of a nation torn apart, and when I felt the valley shake, I knew their grief, I felt their pain. I shouted from the hilltops. I tried to break the chain.
Thank you. Jonathan?
He just got off. Don't wake him.
Sorry I'm late. What's wrong?
I told Jonathan you would take him for a walk up the mountain next Sunday.
Stand still for a minute and talk.
It's late.
Rebecca said she saw you earlier, said you looked as if you'd seen a ghost.
I have looked a ghost. Just like you.
I'm not like Lewis, don't worry.
But you care just as much as he does. The man I fell in love with has a heart as big as Dowling's ironworks.
Elizabeth?
He came to fetch Morgan. He's gone to Thomas Watkins' house.
Megan?
Just 7 years old.
It really makes you think, doesn't it?
What?
What if Lewis is right?
Please come quickly. Back off to sleep now.
Why are you looking scared?
It's nothing, Talia.
It's all right to be scared. Richard says everyone's scared sometimes.
Does he now?
But when I grow up, I won't be scared. I'm going to be like Richard was when he punched that man at it.
I'll have no talk of punching and fighting. You make sure you stay away from that. Do you hear? Just stay safe. Always be safe.
Megan, isn't it?
Isn't she?
I should have been before.
I could have been the doctor! I always the doctor!
She's in heaven now. God will look after her.
How long must we stand?
Jackal of the law here on a day of mourning.
A day of mourning for some leads to a day of sedition for others.
Can't you show this girl's family a hint of respect?
I have every respect for their grief. The girl's death was a horrible tragedy, but it is my duty to ensure that the wrong kind of man does not use this tragedy to urge others towards revolution.
This was a funeral, not a protest.
Ever since these insane radicals started a movement for reform in Merthyr, I've had my
aye, one eye on them, and the other on the coins in your purse.
Hold your tongue. I serve the law and the law alone.
That may be the case, but I doubt you've ever sat at an empty table with a knot of hunger in your belly.
A word to the wise. Stay clear of your unions and reform meetings. No good can come of it.
Oh dear.
cut our wages. Crawshay lays off workers. And then they drove families out of their homes who were in debt simply because they could not afford enough to put bread on their families' tables. Everywhere, people are saying Merthyr is at the centre of the world of industry. Yet we are the ones who break our backs in the dark mines and blazing hell of Carthage, Dallas and Plymouth. So we made Merthyr the centre of the world.
Yes!
So we are the centre of the world.
Yes!
And yet the masters languish in luxury while we starve and watch our children die.
Yes!
No! No!
No!
This is madness. Lewis is calling for a war.
It's not just Lewis. Listen to the crowd. They all want to fight.
Jenkins has called his soldiers from Bretton. They are marching towards Merthyr.
And more from Cardiff.
You have to talk some sense into Lewis.
Yes, violence is never the answer.
And what? Do nothing. That's what we've always done, and look where it's gotten us.
Trust in the Lord, he will guide us.
Your book of prayers isn't going to save us now.
Someone has to do something. Lewis is turning them into a pack of vicious wolves.
Lewis is not to blame for this. The starvation and hunger and tears of grieving mothers is not on his head.
If you won't try to stop this insanity, I will.
Your silence is louder than the screams of the crowd.
You said any words now?
You haven't said anything since Megan's funeral.
Dead.
I want our children to know that I did the right thing.
I know.
Tell me not to go, and I'll stay.
Lewis needs you. No more children dying.
I love you.
Thank you.